solution. Grab a pry bar like this. Put it under it, the drag link, and just pull up on it. And that should. Putting up more pressure. That's about it. Let it go. Boom. Okay. This is loose. Next step is to remove the caliper. Which is removed by these, whatever size this is. I think they're like 30 millimeters. There's four of them. Just place it on top of the axle beam. That's it. And you take off the ABS sensor right there. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, you can see it. Right there is the ABS sensor. just get some pliers and pull that off. I don't have any pliers right now. Knock it off from the inside. Now we're going to take the rotor off. Right now I'm using these clip pliers to take the bearing nut off. So you just use something like a fitting there. You don't know if there's something to take this off and just spread out. I don't have a special tool to remove this. I might, but I probably could just gotta look for it. Just using this for now.
bolts here that you take out. Actually, first you take off the brake shield plate. Of them on each side. You remove it, you remove the bolts on each side, and you push out or punch the pins out.
Over there.
Just gotta pick it up.
So you did the clutch and
I did the clutch on that one, the transmission and the rear.
You guys dropped the whole tranny?
Yeah. Just right here I'm doing the tinkering on.
Yeah, I'm glad I found this place by accident. And I went to the homestead and I live right here and every time I called they were like, you have truck tires? No, we don't do that.
Man, I gotta drive all the way to Medley.
That was Medley. Everyone was telling me, you gotta go to Medley to the truck department truck.
Man.
It's going to the Goodwill here. And then I turn up like, all these trucks. Like, no way. And I pulled in. I seen all these trucks like this. They gotta do this shit. I got lucky. I went to Goodwill that day. Because the next day I was in the road.
They say no because finding mechanics are getting more difficult.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the thing. Finding mechanics are getting way more difficult. That's another nut here on the other side. Sorry about that. That's another nut here on the other side. We're gonna do the same thing. Scoop the nut back in. I'm gonna strike it. So you guys can see. Yeah, that nut there, and that's another one like this on the other side. Alright, I'm gonna strike that. Now there's a top here, one on the bottom, and another one on the top, and another one on the bottom. You want to unscrew that.
El joint ese te quita fuerza.
Sí, yo sé, pero yo pienso que no está ahí tan apretado.
Por eso te le quita fuerza, tienes que poner unos fios. Poner unos fios se coge.
¿Dónde
está la Jim?
Jim, yo
creo que está cambiando los kingpins.
Ahí está.
Cambiando los kingpins.
Ajá.
Si te gusta trabajar aquí.
So they got these tops, one on the top, one on the bottom. Sorry for the interruption. Now, if the key pin doesn't easily slide off, which you're supposed to, but you know, sometimes you're not that lucky. So you gotta use a few things to press it at that point. process are much easier. You don't have to deal with all these extra parts. And then it just slides off. And that's the removal of the kingpin. Hope you guys like the video, like and subscribe. Now, I'll do more stuff. I pretty much post for my own personal record, so sometimes I don't do a job for a long time. I kind of like to go back to see what I did. So, there you go.